Hello and welcome to the first of many videos I plan on producing to kind of show off the EngView software. EngView is a advanced packaging software. It's got a full set of CAD CAM tools. It can run inside of Adobe Illustrator. We run on the Mac, we run on PC, and you can download it right off the web. So right now we're on our webpage here. You'll see there's an option for the 10-day trial. So if you go to EngView.com and click the 10-day trial, then you can try it out. So let's just kind of jump into the software real quick. You'll see all the icons and everything up here. Anywhere you see a little arrow at the lower bottom, that means the dropdown has multiple options. So let's start with our packaging library. There's some 2,000 plus parametric designs in here that are all resizable. So let's just go kind of grab a standard box out of our library. So you can see the box here. If I click this icon, it'll open up in EngView. If I click this one, it'll open in Adobe Illustrator. So let's just start out with EngView. Here's our box. I can kind of move it around, 3D model of the box. If I want to look at it in transparent, I can see through it. If I want to look at it in wireframe, I got that option. We've also got a full set of tools for playing through the opening and closing of the box. So you can kind of see it work its way through there. And let's go over and look at our 2D of the box. We'll turn off our dimensions for a second, and you can kind of see here. So the real power of this is that we can go and we can adjust any of these parameters in real time. It will adjust the box. So let's just go up here and we'll say, we'll make it 4 by 3 by 8. If I click on the glue tab over here, the glue tab you'll see right here is a half inch right now. So you can put in a fraction, or you could put in something like 0.75 minus 0.2 and then it adjusts the glue tab. Or we can even say, hey, we want it to be some factor of B. So let's do B divided by 4. So now every time I adjust B, my glue tab is going to adjust accordingly. So you can see it's kind of like working with Excel. You got a fair amount of power in there. I also can right click down here, go to properties, and this shows me all my materials. If I adjust the thickness of the material, it's also going to adjust the box because it's smart and it just saves you a ton of time. So anyway, that's, let's go look at our 3D real quick too. So now that we have changed, I'm going to go ahead and hit refresh, and you'll see our box just grew. Let's drop back over here. We've, like I said before, we had a full set of CAD tools. So let's go grab our radius tool. Right now it's set to a half inch. I'm gonna go ahead and keep that. And I can radius this, I can radius this. You know, I could take and add a circle in here, et cetera, et cetera. If I go back over and refresh our box, now you can see I got a cutout there. Let's zoom out a little bit. And we'll open it up, and you can see my flaps are now radius. So, and these are just a few, I'm only touching on some small features here, but you can kind of see the quick power. Let's drop over to Adobe Illustrator for a second. And let's open one of our files. So I got this chocolate pillow pack that we designed up. This will pop open in here. And you'll see in here, we've got EngView tools running on this side, so you can actually see our 3D of the pillow pack. Let's drop some graphics on it. So we'll go File, Place. We got our samples. Let's get some images here. We'll go ahead and grab this brown. And let's go drop it in like so. Okay, so now you can see here, we've thrown this design on the pillow pack, and look at it's updated over here. Let's go ahead and edit it, Package Designer. So once we get our pop-up here, you can now see our pillow packs over here. We'll zoom out just a little bit. Let's open it up, zoom all the way out, close it back up. And so let's go ahead and get us a layout. So I'm going to use a one sheet nest. Say okay, lots of different nesting options, multiple sheets. We have a whole library of materials. You can change the sizes. Let's put just a little bit of buffer space in here. And I'm not going to pick a quantity. If I don't, it will just go ahead and fit as many as it can onto the sheet. And you'll see it gives us information like waste. And we'll grab our sheet, finish it up. So now we have a nice sheet nested up. Let's go grab some registration marks so that we can line up our print. We've done that. And now if we close out of here and save it, it will actually drop back into Adobe. Now you don't see that layout yet, but it actually just became up here in our layout window. So let's grab the layout. We'll go ahead and set a bleed. We're going to generate a new drawing. So this drawing here, you'll see that here's all our cut lines that can be sent to our cutting machine with our registration marks. And then we have our print. So, that's print marks. So there's our print. We turn off the die lines. And the print can go to our printer. The cut can go to our cutter. We can export this as a PDF and move on our very way. So anyway, quick little demo of some tools. Plan to show many more, but I hope you enjoyed the demo. Thank you.